Residents flee North Waziristan, a militant sanctuary near Pakistan's border with Afghanistan, where Pakistan's military launched a major campaign on Sunday. Many have fled the Taliban base with few belongings, but find little help.
The people of Waziristan are running around here in vain, but no houses are available, and no other arrangements have been made for us. The weather is extremely hot, and we have children and elderly people with us.
Pakistan's army launched what it calls the Strike of the Prophet's Sword operation a week after a brazen attack on Pakistan's biggest airport in Karachi, which killed 36 people. The government called it the straw that broke the camel's back and vowed to finish off the Pakistani Taliban and Uzbek militants who claimed it.
An operation is going on in North Waziristan. That is why we have been ordered to impose a curfew here and to tighten the security so that no unpleasant incident can occur.
Pakistan has deployed tens of thousands of troops and launched airstrikes, which the military says destroyed six hideouts early Monday. But the Taliban threatened an equally damaging response and warned foreign companies to leave immediately. Six Pakistani soldiers were killed and three injured by an improvised explosive device on Monday. Pakistan's major cities are bracing for the threatened retaliation. Karachi is under red alert, and Islamabad deployed 3,000 extra police. Despite the higher risk of violence, people appear mostly in support of the operation.
This is the right step for the army or the government to take. The Taliban should accept the rules of the government and act according to the laws and constitution of the country.
The military says the operation will take 2 to 3 months and will last until they finish off the Taliban. But they're up against a well-armed enemy in a tribal region no government has ever been able to control. Ralitsa Vassileva, CNN.